So spraying in Valorant is similar to that of CSGO, but it has some different challenges. What's up everyone, I'm Tyznips, and this video is gonna be a spray guide for Valorant. I'll explain how recoil works and simple and easy steps to practice that will take you from not really knowing how to spray to being much more confident in getting those long distance spray downs. Before we begin though, YouTube has this bug that shows that only a small percentage of you guys are actually subscribed. So if you could scroll down quickly and just double check if there's a big red button down there that says subscribe. If there is, click it and make it gray. Once you've done that, let me know down below and I can tell YouTube to change their stats. Now, without further ado, this is your guide to spraying in Valorant. So if you're watching this, you obviously know that Valorant has recoil. It's not like Call of Duty, more like CSGO. You can't just point and shoot a whole clip in the same area without all but two bullets going off in what seems like an uncontrollable manner. But you actually can control it, to an extent. See, with Counter-Strike, the spray pattern for the guns is consistent whenever you spray, meaning that if you learn the pattern and how to compensate for it, you can almost completely control where the bullets will hit. Valorant is different in that, yes, the bullets do have a spray pattern, but the horizontal sway is random. There might be more bullets that hit the left side or more bullets that hit the right side. So it's hard to say that you can completely control the weapon spray, but this horizontal spray is not going to stop you from getting those multiple kill spray downs or those long distance sprays. Learning how to spray is definitely still essential for those situations where you have to get multiple kills or you have to spray transfer to another enemy. Now let's look at the spray pattern for these three guns. The Vandal definitely has the most intense and exaggerated spray pattern. It's the one that you have to compensate for the most. You can see that once the spray reaches its maximum height, it platforms off in a sort of round shape. The Phantom doesn't have as much vertical recoil as the Vandal. As you can see, when it tops off, it forms a platform that's a lot flatter than that of the Vandal as well. Now the Bulldog has a smaller vertical distance to compensate for, but the top is similar to that of the Vandal. You can see though that the spray pattern is similar between all of these guns, but they all have their unique twists. And again, they're all also affected by that random horizontal sway at the top of the spray. So I've split the spray into two stages, the first stage being the vertical stage. Now this stage only lasts for the first 8 bullets for all of the guns. They won't start to show much vertical recoil until after the 8th bullet. This is definitely the most important stage for most situations and is where you should be getting a majority of your kills when you spray. So first, let's look into mastering stage one. It really is quite simple. Because the recoil takes you straight up, you pull straight down. The amount you physically pull down though will depend on your sensitivity and also the gun that you're using. A high sense means that you won't have to pull down as much as if you have a low sensitivity. Now, I say it's simple, but it definitely requires a lot of practice to get good at, and I'll tell you how I practice my spray later on in the video. If you have a single enemy in front of you and you start spraying, you don't want to go past stage one. This stage has plenty of bullets to kill an enemy and it's the easiest part of the spray to control, so you'll get more consistent kills with it. Also, the closer you are to the target, the less you're going to have to compensate for your spray. And this means that the further away you are, the more you'll have to compensate. Now, stage two is a lot more complex. This is the horizontal part of the spray and lasts for the remainder of the bullets in the clip. For the Vandal, from the peak of stage one, the bullets start to drift to the right a bit, then to the left hard, and then back to the right, all while also being in this sort of semi-circle area. Now, the Phantom doesn't really drift off too much to the right. It does a little bit in stage one, but it goes really far to the left and then comes back to the right. Like I said earlier though, this stage is very flat for the Phantom in comparison to the Vandal. For the Bulldog though, it's the opposite. First it starts to go to the left and then the right and then back to the left. We can see though that the maximum distance the bullets go from the left to the right is pretty equal to the distance in the middle. Stage 2 is where it gets a lot harder to control and requires a lot more training. You don't really want to be getting into stage 2 to kill a single enemy. This is what you'll be using to get multi-kill spray downs and also transferring to an enemy that's somewhere else. This will also require you to learn multiple spray patterns and also which one to use for the gun that you're using. Now that we know more about the spray patterns for these guns, how do you start training for them? To begin, hop into the range and get a feel for the weapons that you use most. If you're a Vandal person, then start with the Vandal. If you're a Phantom person, then you start with the Phantom. Although I do recommend that you do learn the spray pattern for all the essential rifles like the Vandal, Phantom, and Bulldog. What you can do is set the target at different distances and start to feel out how much you have to be compensating for vertical and horizontal recoil. To begin though, start with mastering stage one. Start spraying and try and control the first 8 bullets as best as you can. Then once you start getting better, start to control even more of the clip. It's a skill and you train it with repetition and practice. You just have to keep on grinding at it. You can go to the bots and see what it's like to start spraying at a player model. Once you've been doing this and you can see that your spray is improving, now is when the hard part comes in. Now you want to be controlling the spray for spray transfers and longer sprays. To start, long distance sprays are a lot harder because you have to compensate a lot more. Now, it isn't completely necessary to train your very long range sprays, but it will help you improve your spray overall. Just start trying to practice spraying at the target from further and further distances. Now, the next thing you can do is start spraying at the target and then transferring to the bot on the right. Do this so that you can start to feel what it's like to have to readjust your spray after switching to a new target. You can practice transferring after a few bullets or transferring after half the clip. I recommend that you do it for lots of different times because you never know how fast you're gonna get that first kill. You wanna be prepared for all of it. Then once you start to get the hang of that, you wanna start going from bot to bot. Let me know down below how many bots you can kill in one spray transfer clip. Then to start putting all this into practical use, go into a deathmatch and start playing. It's better to go into a deathmatch than a competitive game because you spend more time in aim duels. Playing deathmatches will give you more dynamic and realistic training compared to just spraying at the target and at bots. shots. You'll be exposed to more real angles, distances, and player reactions. Go into the deathmatch with the intent of spraying though. Yes, you might already have very good aim and crosshair placement and you can one-tap your way to victory, but that's not the point. You're trying to improve your spray, so use the time to improve it. Overall, your spray will improve the more you train to improve it. But this breakdown on tips on how you can better optimize your time to start improving it faster should make that easier for you. Easier for you to put the work in, that is. At the end of the day, spraying just requires you to compensate for a pattern. So the more you do it and ingrain it into your muscle memory, the better you will get at compensating for that pattern. This isn't to say that you should be spraying all the time though. I do believe that it's very important to know how to spray because there are situations where you will need it. Times where you might have the opportunity for a big spray down or where you might have to transfer to another target. But you should be aiming to get more kills from quick 2 to 3 bullet bursts like this. You're getting the kill quick and you're saving more bullets in the clip for if any more people peek you. If you do want to start improving all the areas of your aim though, I do have an aim training playlist linked down below. It has videos that'll help improve your crosshair placement and your raw aiming ability and much more. Thanks for watching and hopefully I see you in the video that you click next.